Oh, Mr. Gennaro.
You're Superman.
I'm expecting someone. I will not have time to chat this morning.
Oh, this is not a chat call. I'm sorry. Not a social visit, you see.
No, I'm sorry. I do not see.
Mrs. Agata,
I forgot to put these out this morning.
Mrs. Agata,
You'll have to excuse me this morning, Mr. Gennaro. I'm not in the world today.
Mrs. Goddard, how are things, huh?
Things are things. How else should they be? That's better. I'm alive. I suppose that's something.
I know what you mean. It's just like me. Alive and alone, just like you.
Oh, Mr. Gennaro, the faucet in the bathroom needs fixing.
I'll take care.
No, not now. Later. I'm expecting a pupil any minute now.
Oh, a new pupil. Oh, that's nice. You're going to give us singing lessons again, huh?
Well, I'm not so sure if I will after today. It's a very difficult decision. He's a nice young man, but he doesn't have very much talent. I don't think there's a thing I can do with him.
No.
You know, I'm not one of those unprincipled teachers trading on the hopes and dreams of the young.
You're a fine woman, Mrs. Goddard, a woman of principle.
Yes. Yes, Mr. Gennaro, I am a woman of principle.
A finer woman. Now, that's why my situation is so difficult to have to bring up...
Why don't you come back later?
Well, you know, it's about the rent.
I see.
The new owner, he told me he's coming by today.
Good. Then ask him about the new refrigerator he's been promising me.
You make it very hard for me.
Look, it isn't even the 15th of the month.
Of this month, right. But there's last month and the month before. That's a 3 months of rent.
We are speaking of less than $400, sir, not the national debt.
All right. I'm sorry. I don't say no more. Look, you know, if it was me, you could live here for nothing. I owe you. I owe you maybe $100,000, all the pleasure you and your husband have given me. I go to the opera all the time, but it's not the same. When he dies, it's like a golden voice go off from this world.
He had his good nights.
You don't mean that.
I do, too, mean that. 7 years after his death doesn't change that fact.
Mrs. Goddard, you got to do something about the rent. The new owner, he's not a gentleman. He's not a gentleman either. He thinks because I let it go so long, you and me, you know...
Mr. Gennaro.
I'm sorry, but I got to tell him something is on my neck. Maybe you could sell your stock.
My stock? Oh, yes, my stock.
Sure, I know the market is lousy, but you can get us something, maybe borrow.
No, I never borrow.
No, I mean from the bank, or collateral, you know. That's...
Thank you for your kind interest.
All right. You know, I gotta tell him something.
Tell him about the refrigerator.
Yes, ma'am.
Insight, stories of spiritual conflict in the 20th century. We're all tempted to adopt poses of superiority. We're better than other people. We don't need them. Come on. We all share the same pains and problems of being human. And because we do, we're like other people. We need them. We cling to these poses because we don't like who we are. We're afraid to take a good look at ourselves, afraid that if we do, we'll be appalled. It is true that there is a lot of guilt and fear and pain within us, but that's only on the surface. Beneath is our real self. And that's very beautiful indeed. You're so much more lovable than you think you are.
Mrs. Goddard speaking.
Your pupil, you alone?
No, my pupil's late as always, an hour late. Why?
Shh. He's downstairs here.
No. The new owner. Yes, I told him that you wasn't in, but he won't believe me.
Will you please speak up? What's the matter with you?
Listen, this is a serious. You gotta do something about it. He's got it, the paper. No. The paper from the court.
He's not gonna take a no for an answer.
Papers don't frighten me, and neither does your whispery voice. Now you stop it. You're late.
Mrs. G, I am so sorry. I ran into some gypsies that I haven't seen in ages. I just started rapping. I don't know. I guess I got hung up.
Gypsies on 79th Street.
Well, you know what I'm talking about. Dancers. I really am very sorry.
Oh, that's all right, Edward. That's all right. It gave me an opportunity to think about your voice lessons. Now, if you remember, when you came to me 3 weeks ago, I said there would have to be a period.
My, someone's in a hurry.
Mrs. Gollard.
Mr. Watkins.
Watkins, as I'm sure you know. What a surprise to find you home.
Won't you please come in?
Can we speak privately, or do I open up in front of him?
My, aren't you the woodsman?
Who is he, your interior decorator?
He's my pupil, so you can see that I'm rather busy. This will have to be postponed. Perhaps I can give you a few minutes this afternoon. Yes, why don't you come back this afternoon?
There are no more postponements. If he really is your pupil, then our business shouldn't take long. The interruption will last only as long as it takes for you to write me out a check.
Hey, that's no way to talk.
What?
Edward, give us 5 minutes, please.
Surely. I'll go down and get some breakfast.
Nothing heavy.
$382.20.
Oh, Mr. Watkins, I have a savings account, not a checking account. Checking accounts have always been such a mystery to me.
I'll be glad to walk to the bank with you.
I don't have $382.
I didn't think you had.
But there should be no problem in a week or two.
Mrs. Goddard, I don't enjoy this. I'm not a sadist, but I'm answerable to three other partners. This building is only one of five our corporation owns. We're businessmen, Mrs. Goddard, not philanthropists. You can see what would happen if we began to give exceptions like this to everybody.
I should think the fact that I lived here for 5 years would count for something. The owner was so happy when I moved in. Prestige, he said. This will give the building prestige. My husband was Lawrence Goddard. Now, anybody who knows anything about the opera at all...
I know all about your late husband. I don't want to hear about the stock either, since you sold it 8 months ago.
How did you find that out?
What's the difference? We know. Maybe it's time you came down a peg.
You know this is idiotic. Idiotic! I had an 8-room apartment on Riverside Drive for 15, 16 years. And no one has the temerity.
Please.
You call this a refrigerator? This noise box? This monster? Well, come and take a look. Does that look like I am living high on the hog? Just what peg are you referring to?
Getting excited isn't a solution either, is it?
I don't know how I have managed to live for 5 years in this roach-infested garbage pile.
Then you won't mind moving, will you? In fact, all things considered, I'm doing you a favor. You find a cheaper place, we'll both be happy.
Oh, Mr. Watkins, since you know so much about me, you must know I have to give voice lessons. My husband's insurance was a trickle of sand. I can't give voice lessons in just any building.
We've instituted eviction proceedings, Mrs. Goddard. We've been more than patient.
I put an ad in the paper last week for new pupils.
You have a pupil. Get an advance from him.
Oh, no. No, Mr. Watkins, he's not the one. But I will find a pupil. I will find a pupil that I will put into the Metropolitan because I have connections and I'm a good teacher. Oh, as a matter of fact, I'm a great teacher.
You're such a great teacher. Why don't you do something for that nice boy, the interior decorator? He's a bird in the hand, Mrs. Goddard.
No. His voice offends me. You see, I do not put money above talent. I am a woman of principle, Mr. Watkins. A woman of principle.
I'm the first to admire principle, but as you're beginning to discover, principle doesn't pay the rent.
And I say thank God for that. I say thank God there are things in this world that are more important than rent.
Yeah. There's eviction. And you have the papers.
Mr. Watkins?
What?
You have a home.
Yeah.
You have a family.
Mm-hmm.
A wife.
Yeah.
Give me a chance.
All right. Look, we'll hold off for another 24 hours.
24 hours?
I tell my partners you weren't home.
But that's only a day.
So you pay me up to this month. What is it? $254.80.
Oh, I don't understand figures.
And then you're going to have to the first. But then I got to have the arrears in the next month.
The language. I don't understand the language. I never understood
anything. Mrs. Goddard, come down to Earth. Join the rest of us.
$24
How? I've done all I can. You have a family, a daughter, don't you? Call her.
We haven't spoken in 3 years.
Well, maybe it's time you said hello. But that's your business. Mine's real estate. Good luck.
Coming along, isn't it? You know, it's much easier for me when you play the arpeggios. I can concentrate more on placing the voice. You listening? Mrs. G, I don't even think you're listening.
What?
I was wondering how it's been sounding. You said today you'd decide, do I continue or not?
I said that?
3 weeks ago. What's the matter with you today, dear? Was it that creep, that bill collector?
Oh, no, no, no. That was a legal matter. My late husband used to speculate in real estate. That is, his business manager always invested in...
Whatever. How about it?
How about what?
The lessons.
Oh, Edward, I'm sorry. The lessons. Well, Edward, you need a lot of work.
I'm aware of that.
Yes, you should have 2 lessons a week at least.
2?
Yes, 3 would be better, but 2 will be all right. Don't worry, I'll make you a rate.
2 lessons a week? For how long?
Edward, you have the kind of voice that will respond best to classical training. So I think we shall start with Puccini. Puccini.
For crying out loud, I'm no opera singer.
No, but a trained voice cannot be developed by going up and down the scales and singing silly tunes. Verdi will do more for a singing career than 10 weeks of scales.
A singing career, huh? Dear, I'm a dancer. I told you that. A dancer.
Of course, I know that, and you move very well. But, Edward, you have great potential. And with the proper guidance, my guidance, you will be astonished. Oh, Edward, trust me. Put yourself in my hands.
Mrs. G, I came to you for one reason. I've been missing out on singing parts. Broadway is where I'm at, musicals. Now, I just want to carry a tune, that's all. I told you that.
Oh... You'll do much more than that. Carry a tune, indeed. You will do much, much, much more than that, Edward. But even I cannot perform miracles. I will need at least 6 months. Now, Edward, about the arrangements. I will need 20 weeks in advance.
20 weeks in advance?
Yes, in advance. Let's see, two a week for $15 instead of 10 each. Payable today or tomorrow is satisfactory. Tomorrow.
Mrs. Goddard, I don't want any Verdi or any repertoire or any of that junk. I don't even like opera.
You will like opera with me?
No. I came to you for one reason. I was told that you were in financial difficulty and that you would give me a break. Well, why do you think I put up with all this Giovanni this and Lucrezia that?
Edward.
All those hideous, screechy records you made me listen to. And now you want 20 weeks in advance, huh? Well, you can just forget it, Madam Butterfly. You can just forget the whole thing.
You get out!
Don't worry. Oh, and the $30 I owe you? Sue me, Mary.
Hello, Linda. Oh, Janie. Janie, you're growing up so much, I thought you were Linda. Janie, it's Grandma. No, it's Grandma, Janie. Janie, may I speak to your mommy, please? Janie, I can't take the time at the moment to talk about your dollies. Janie, I want to speak to your mommy. Janie, I have to speak to your mommy, please. Janie, I don't think that's very nice. But Janie, how do you know she doesn't want to speak to me? But Janie, I want to speak to your mommy. Janie? Janie? Go to hell.
Fai, pagliaccio.
Mrs. Garland, how are you? I was shaving and singing. I don't hear nothing.
I would like that fixed.
Well, sure. Well, maybe could wait. I'm getting dressed to go out.
Well, I spoke to you about it this morning, Mr. Gennaro. I think I've waited long enough.
All right. I get dressed and I come right up. Huh?
Now, I would like to wait.
Oh, sure. You'd like to come in? Please. Hello, Charlie. How's everything? I have some hot water. You'd like to make a tea? Please, help yourself. I get dressed. Excuse me, huh?
I've never been in the basement before.
Ah, you don't know what you've been missing. I have a picture gallery, too.
It's your wife?
Yes.
She's dead.
Several years. I have a many picture, but I like to keep this one to refresh my mind of how she looked then. The way she looked later is still here.
I didn't know you had children.
Oh, sure. That one in the middle, that's a sallow. He was a wild boy. Automobile accident, smash up. The police say he stole a car. Maybe, maybe no, I don't know. He died in the ambulance.
I'm sorry.
He's in the army, a pilot in the Texas. And that's my daughter. Isn't she something, huh? She's in a college in California. Wait, I'll show you something. Here. See? She's what you call an anarchist. She goes to class between demonstrations, but she gets a good marks.
Well, I suppose that's something.
Oh, I'm proud of her. She loves the people. She can tell a real person from a phony just like that. It's a talent she has. You know, if you knew her, she would be your friend.
Mr. Gennaro, I'm surprised at you, a man of your years, being so naive. Santa Claus and friends. I gave up a long time ago believing in friends.
Well, then you should have met her. She would make you believe in friends again. Maybe not in Santa Claus, but in friends, sure.
Don't patronize me, Mr. Gennaro. Please fix this. And come up when you can spare your valuable time.
Oh, no, please, don't. No, 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 please, stay. You like to sit down? Please. Here. Don't be like that. Sure. Sure. I understand, you know, about the rent. It's very difficult for you, huh?
I'll manage.
How?
I think that's my business.
Look, I'm your friend.
You're my friend because of my husband, by your own admission.
Believe in me, if I had $354.80, I would give it to you.
I do not take money from strangers.
I'm sorry, I don't mean that. I mean, there must be some way. Let me think. You know, maybe you could go to work. I mean, just for the emergency, huh?
I've never worked a day in my life, Mr. Gennaro. I can't do anything. What would I do? What good am I? Who would want me?
And about a family? I know sometimes the children get angry with their mama, papa, but still a daughter and a mother are pretty close.
She won't even come to the phone.
I have a friend. He go to the welfare.
I'm not a charity case, not a beggar on the street.
I'm sorry. I don't mean. Look, maybe you have a friend. You and your husband know so many people.
Oh, Mr. Gennaro. When my husband was alive, we had an army of friends. Then one by one, they showed their true colors.
So many people, all a phony?
No. No. I wouldn't say they were phony. But he was gone, the great voice, the lion, the celebrity, and I was a widow of someone, but I was nothing, and who wants a friend that is a nothing?
Now, look, don't say that, nothing. Who's a nothing? Everybody's a something. What am I? I'm a super, huh? What do? I take out the garbage, I lock up at night, I change a bulb, I fix the faucet, but still, I'm a something. I'm a me. And of that, I think I can be proud. I am a proud, and you should be proud too.
Me?
Yes! Look, if you like it to have a super for a friend, all you gotta do is to say the word. But you gotta take me like I am, Not try to change me for somebody else, but just like I am.
I don't know you very well, Mr. Gennaro.
Let's have some tea. That helps get acquainted.
Well, I don't like to take up your time.
No, I have a plenty of time. Hey, I'm going to the opera tonight. You know, it's Manon Lescaut just by a strange coincidence. Maybe you'd like to come along, huh?
I haven't been to the opera in a long time.
Then please come. I'll show you a Manon like you've never seen it before.
I've seen Manon 100 times.
As a standee? When you come with me, you don't see an opera in a bigger box with a bunch of strangers, no. You see it with a bunch of friends who love the opera for the music. And then after we go have some coffee, maybe a little vino, and a sing, and have a fun.
Well, I could never be ready in time.
What are you talking, you? For a standee, you're overdressed. Huh? Please.
Mr. Gennaro. Huh? Would you understand if I told you I could not go tonight because I have this day to think over.
Oh, sure, I would understand, sure. I'd be disappointed, but I understand.
We'll go one night, maybe a Faust.
You like a sugar in your tea?
Oh, no, I never take sugar in... All right, I will have sugar in my tea. I'll try it. But I want the tea very hot, you understand, Mr. Gennaro. The tea must be very hot.
Why, sure. No woman of a principle, a drink of tea that's a lukewarm.
Insight is a production of the Paulist Fathers, a group of Catholic priests who serve their God by serving those outside their church.